Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel and this amazing video, I'm Aditya. In this video, we are going to see concept of Svelte built-in components or elements. So without any further ado, let's begin. Okay, so let's take example of this Svelte cell. So what does it do? Okay, so if I go over here, I have created a recursive component, which is just a simple component, which has this counter. So I'm just taking example from here, where we are having a count as a prop, and then we are showing like if the count is greater than 0, then we just display the count with the Svelte self. Now what this Svelte self is gonna do? Well, this Svelte self is gonna replace this thing over here with the component itself. Now one thing to notice is you can only use Svelte self inside a block. So it could be inside if block or each block. Now to see how it looks in a recursive way, let's make this count as 10. Now, if you make this count as 10, you will see it's just 10, 9, 8, 7, da da da, and liftoff. So in this way, we can have the same component have it rendered again and again in a recursive way, and then we just need a terminating condition like when we should stop making it as a we just stop rendering the same component again and again. Cool. Now next thing is Svelte component. Now sometimes you might want to render components dynamically. Well, last time we saw how we can lazy load the component in some previous videos, but sometimes you might, let's say we are not sure whether we want to render counter component or card component. So to give an example, let's say we have here some component and we want to render that component based on a condition. Let's say we want to render it based on, say, a flag or a condition or certain things. So let's bring in the card component first and also the counter component, and let's take a simple condition here. So here I'm going to say let condition equal to true. For now I'm going to keep it true. Now here let's say we want to render the counter component if the condition is true, but we want to render the card component if the condition is false. So for that we could use Svelte component, and here we just need to pass the name of that component. So here we just need to say if condition, if it's true, then we render counter, else we render card. If we go back over here and check it out, you will see we are getting the counter component. Now if we make that condition false over here, now you will see we will get the card component. There we go. So this is how you could have the component dynamically rendered with Svelte component. Next we have Svelte window and Svelte body. Now sometimes you might want to listen to the HTML body elements event. In this case we have the body tag over here, but sometimes you might want to listen to the events happening on that body tag. Let's say we want to listen for someone like, let's say, hovering on that body tag or load or some any other event. So how can we do that? Well, we can simply use Svelte body or window, body, and here we can listen for that event. Let's say we say on load, so whenever the body tag is loaded, we just will alert loaded. So we just need to bring it over here, and that should be fine. We just need to make sure that Svelte body element is not inside any HTML element. And if we go back over here, you will see if we reload this page, you will see nothing happens. Now if I change this to something else, let's say on click, there we go, we have that loaded over there. Now this is how you could listen to the body events. Now let's go to the next one, which is Svelte head. Now this component or this element I find personally very powerful, because if you notice here we have something over here, it is like V plus Svelte. Now in single page application, of course SEO doesn't matter, or you least care about it, but we just want to make sure that the tab title and everything is rendered properly. So for that we could use Svelte head. So I could do something like this, Svelte head and inside this I just need to put all the head tag elements. So in this, let's say I put title, say Svelte app. Now here it will again throw an error showing that cannot be inside blocks or elements. So we just need to make sure that we put it outside the HTML like this. So Svelte app. Now if we go back and see our you will see here we have the heading as Svelte app. Also we can add other things over here, maybe some external scripts or links or CSS, all that we can add it over here, right? Then we have Svelte fragment. Now Svelte fragment is somewhat similar to React fragment. Here for the card component we have slot name as content, like over here. Now inside our card list we were rendering that as a span tag over here, but let's say we don't want to render it as a span tag, we just want to render it as it is. So here we could use Svelte fragment, and then if we just render the card list, so let's bring that back and let's render the card list over here. Card list, there we go. And if we see that again over here, you will see we get the card list. Now if I I just need to remove that because it's listening for the click event. This one. Now if you notice, if I go over here and inspect this part, you will see that for the card, this one over here, we have the p tag straight inside the div tag. It's not wrapped in a span tag. Because if you notice, we are doing the same thing here. We are putting the content inside a span, div tag. So we can use Svelte fragment to avoid extra wrapping of those tag, or we can avoid like having those tag wrapped in another tag. We can also render tags dynamically using Svelte element. So in this case, let's say here we have the fragment. Now in this case we want this tag to be sometimes div tag, sometimes p tag, sometimes some other tag. So here we could say Svelte element, and then we just need to say what tag we want to render. So let's give this as a div tag. Now if we go back over here again, you will notice that if I expand any one of these tags, to the card list, so over here, here and over here, you will see we have that div tag and then we have the p tag. So our element is wrapped inside a div tag. So if we go back over here again, you'll see that okay, this div slot element. Okay, let's give this let's make this as a span tag so that we can see it as a span tag so it's not confusing. So if I go back over here again, open one card, open div, and you will see we have the span tag wrapping the p tag. So we can also have HTML tags rendered dynamically. So that's all in this video. In the next video, we will see the concept of routing. So till the next time, goodbye.